गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, आई होप दैट ऑल यू आर वेल एट होम एंड यू आर रिवाइजिंग वट वी आर कवरिंग इन द वीडियोज. नाउ इन टूडेज वीडियो आई वॉन्ट टू अनाउंस वन मोर थिंग दैट वी आर सेंडिंग होमवर्क थ्रू स्नैप ऐप. इट इज़ मोर कन्वीनियंट टू यू दैट यू विल डू योर होमवर्क फ्रॉम दैट बिकॉज यू कैन गेट द पी डी एफ फाइल्स इमेजेस मोर क्लियर. सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट how the situation is demanding. Okay, this is a way of teaching and learning as well, that you have to use this digital methods. I know in the starting you feel that they are not that much comfortable, but that is necessary, okay, as per the situation. So whatever we are doing, you have to follow them. Okay, so if you are sending the homework of Snap app, you are going to use that regularly. It is more convenient for you because you can now, you will have the stationary images through that. We can send you the images of the books also, whatever we are doing, you can assess from that. Okay, so be regular from checking your homework and doing your homework from Snap app. Now exercise 1B we are doing, up to question number 5th we have done. Now today we will start with question number 6. I hope in the previous videos what I have covered, you are having no problem or no such issues. You have understood well, you have practiced well. If anything is still there, don't worry. In your notebook where you are solving the questions, just write your doubt with pencil there, okay? So that you can, whenever you are going to meet with me, I can take your doubts directly, okay? So don't worry about your doubts. Definitely they will be resolved. But first your work is that you will continuously watch the videos until and unless you are not getting the clarity. Watch them again and keep on practicing, okay? Now I am starting question number 6. So this is exercise 1B and I am starting question number 6 of the exercise. Now verify the following. In class 7th also we have done such types of verification. Always for verifying we have to solve the left hand side and right hand side, and then we will decide that they are getting equal or not. In this situations they are saying that they are not equal, they are not equal. In such a situation answer of left hand side will not come equal to the right hand side and it will be hence proof. And if they are saying that they are equal, then their answer should come equal of left hand side and right hand side, they will give the same answer. Same here it will not be the same answer because they are saying it is not equal. So have a look of question number 6, copy in your notebook. Okay, now you can see one thing, that I have sent the picture of the exercise 1B on Snap app. So you can copy from that in your notebook, and when I am explaining through video tutorial, there is no need to write again and again the question. You are having the whole exercise with you. So whenever I am sending any picture on Snap app, first work that copy all the questions, so that when you are watching the video, questions are on your hand, in your hand, and you can solve from there, and better way of understanding it will be, okay, if you are having the questions with you in advance. Now the first part, this is the first part, second part, third part and fourth part. Now see the solution, how we will solve these questions. So this is the solution of part 1. Here there are two sides, one is left hand and second is right hand. I will solve them separately and then decide that they are equal or not. Now see the solution. First I am taking left hand side, 1 minus 7 minus 3 by 5. As you can see, the denominators are not equal, therefore I will take the LCM. LCM of 7 and 5 is 35. Now both are the prime numbers, so there will not be any other factor. So you can directly multiply 75 ja 35. There is no need to take the LCM. LCM becomes necessary to take when you are having any common factor between them. Okay, otherwise you can directly just multiply. Now 35. Now make them equal to 35. For making them equal to 35, denominators 75 ja 35, 57 ja 35. Same number you will provide to your numerators which you have given to denominators. Now solve the multiplication. 51 ja 5, 57 ja 35, 37 ja 21, 57 ja 35. Now you can see that your denominators are equal. Now you can merge the fractions. It will be 5 minus 21 upon 35. Now they are having different sign. So 5 will be subtracted from 21. If you subtract 5 from 21, answer will be 16. Now 21 is a greater numeric value and it is negative. That's why my answer is negative. Sign is very important to assign. Always remember, in multiplication, in division, addition, subtraction, my last step that I will check for sign, that what sign my answer will carry. Okay, don't think that my answer is also 1635, what happen if I am not putting negative? No, it will change the meaning completely. Okay, 16 upon 35 does not equal to minus 16 upon 35. Understood? Sign is very important. After solving question, after doing the calculations, you have to cross check that the calculated answer will carry which sign. Okay, pay attention when you are assigning the sign. Now solve the right hand side. Again 3 by 5 minus 1 by 7, denominators is 5, 7, LCM will be as it is 35. Now you will try to make denominators equal to 35. For that purpose, you will multiply with the number 5, 7 ja 35, 7, 5 ja 35. Same number you will provide to your numerators. 3, 7 ja 21, 5, 7 ja 35, 5, 1 ja 5, 7, 5 ja 35. Now denominators are same. Now you can merge the figures. 21 minus 5 upon 35. Now if you are subtracting 5 from 21, there also you have subtracted 5 from 21, here also, but one difference is there. You can see now why we are saying that sign is that much important, because here 21 is a greater numeric value and here also, but one difference is there that here 21 is positive. That's why my answer is positive. Here 21 is negative, answer is negative. And you can see that minus 16 upon 35 does not equal to positive 16 upon 5. Hence prove, that means these two values are not equal. Why? Because it is giving me negative answer and this is giving me positive answer. Minus 4 is not equal to plus 4. That's why it is hence prove that this side is not equal to that side. Now I will solve the second part. So this is my second part. Now you can see here, again left hand side and right hand side is there and question is saying they are not equal. Okay, one property I am remembering that we have done in rational number, that there is commutative property. Commutative property means if you are adding two numbers, if you are adding two numbers and you change the order, answer will not change. That's why we are saying in rational numbers, in addition of rational numbers, commutative properties prevails. That means that is true, but in subtraction it is not there. In the previous question also you are saying that if you change the order, you are not getting the same answer. Okay, if you are changing the order in subtraction, you have changed the order here. Okay, if you are changing the order, you will not get the same answer. Understood? So that's why in subtraction commutative property is not applied. Now left hand side, minus 3, no denominator is there, that's why I put 1, it will not change anything. Again 1 and 14, I will take the LCM, 14, that means I will convert this 1 into 14, I will multiply with 14 for that purpose. Okay, 14 threes are 42, minus sign as it is, 14 will be 14, this number as it is. Now denominators are same, now you can solve, minus 42, minus 5, same sign, add the numbers. If same sign is there, add the numbers, 47, assign the common sign. This is your answer. Now check on the right hand side. Again the same procedure. I will put 1 there. And if double sign is there, first of all my duty is to convert them into single sign. Wait now. Let me set the camera first. Yes. Now it's okay. Now make them single sign, minus minus plus. Again LCM will be taken, 14. I will convert this 1 into 14. For that purpose, I again multiply with 14. 14 3 ja 42, 14 1 ja 14. Now you will add the numbers. Now both the digits are positive, so answer is positive addition. Now you can again see this is negative 47 upon 14. This is positive. They cannot be said that they are equal, and hence prove. That's why we are saying in subtraction of rational number, commutative property does not prevails. Now I am moving to third part. It is very easy to say that if you are adding 0, if you are subtracting 0, my answer will be same. Okay, when you see this question, okay, it is very easy. 0 is 0, okay, it will not have any impact and you will write down same answer. But here you have to prove. Okay, and when you have to prove, you will show your calculation. Now, how you will show your calculations? See here, 0 is there. Whenever addition of 0 or subtraction of 0 we have to do, first thing which we will do is that whatever denominator is there with the second number, same we will apply to the both side. Okay, I can multiply like that 15 into 15, because if I multiply 0 with any number, answer is 0. So it will not change anything, so I can multiply. Okay, same numbers I will provide to both the sides, numerator and denominator. Now if you multiply 0 into 15 is 0 and 15 as it is. Now you can take the LCM. Okay, no need to take the LCM, denominators are same. Now if denominators are same, just merge the figure, minus 8 minus 0. And if you are subtracting from 0 from 8, same answer you will get, and minus 8 upon 15 as it is you get, and which is given to you on right hand side, which is equal to right hand side, hence proof. That means if you are adding 0 or you are subtracting 0, it will not affect your number. Okay, the same number itself you get as the answer. Now I will move to the next question. Now this is the question of associative property, because three numbers are there, and if three numbers are there and you are changing their order in addition, you will get the same answer. That's why we are saying that in addition of rational number, commutative and associative, both the properties applies. But here you can see that I am saying that they are not equal. If I am changing the order in subtraction, you will not get the same answer. That's why we are saying in rational number, while you are subtracting, commutative and associative property does not prevail. Okay, I am repeating my line. Associative and commutative property does not prevail in subtraction of rational number. Okay, and you can see the proof here also. Okay, if you are changing the order in addition and if you are changing the order in subtraction, you will not get the same answer. Changing order is not allowed in subtraction. That is the only reason that commutative and associative property are not applying in subtraction of rational number. Now left hand side, first I will take 5 by 8 minus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 7. Bracket is there, for therefore as per Bodmer's, first I will solve the bracket. For solving the bracket, I will take the LCM of 8 and 3. 8 threes are 24, because no common factor is there, I can directly multiply. 8 threes are 24. Now I will convert my denominators equal to 24. That's for that purpose I will multiply with 3. 8 threes are 24. 3 8s are 24, same number I will give here. Now solve it. 5 threes are 15, 8 threes are 24, 8 ones are 8, 3 8s are 24. Now denominators are same, so 24 as it is, and 15 minus 8 is 7. This number I am just carry down as it is, okay, because first I am solving the bracket. Now bracket is solved. Now these two numbers I am having. Now again I will take the LCM of 24 and 7. LCM of 24 and 7 is 168. Now again there is no common factor between 24 and 7, so I can directly multiply these numbers. Okay, now for 24 I will multiply here 7, so that I can get this number. Same number I will provide to my numerator, and same here. Now solve this multiplication. 7 7 ja 49, 24 7 ja 168. Now 2 multiply with 24 is 48, and then 168. Now denominators are same, merge the figures. 49 minus 48, and if you subtract 48 from 49, answer will be 1 upon 168. 49 is greater numeric value, answer is positive. Now check your right hand side. First I will solve the bracket. Take the LCM 21. After taking LCM, convert the denominators equal to 21. That's for that purpose I have multiplied 7 here and 3 here. The same number I will give to the numerator. Now 7 1 7, 3 7 21, 2 3 6, 7 3 21. Now you can see denominators are same. Now you can merge the figures. 7 minus 6, if you are subtracting 6 from 7, answer will be 1. Rest of the things, when I am solving the bracket, rest of the things I have carried just as it is. Okay, now once the bracket is solved, now I can open it. Now 5 by 8 minus 1 upon 21, again I will take the LCM, it is 168. Now I will convert my denominators equal to 168. For that purpose I will multiply with 21 and here I multiply with my number 8. The same number I will give to my numerators. So if you multiply, you will get this value. Okay, 8 1 8 and 168 and this value. Now denominators are same. Now you can subtract the number, 105 minus 8, 97. Now you can see how much change is there. It is 1 upon 168, it is 97 upon 168. So you can see that the numbers you are having is same. 5 by 8 minus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 7, same number is here. 5 by 8 minus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 7. Only the thing which you have done is just you have changed the order of subtraction. So that's why this is associative property. If addition of rational number is there, then this property lies, no problem is there if you are changing the order. But in subtraction this property will not apply. Why? You have seen the solution. Okay, because you are not getting the same answer. Now I am moving to the next question. Now question number 7. First see the question. Next question is here. Simplify the following equations. This is similar to question number 3 which we have done. Okay, only now the bracket is there and numbers has enlarged, plus that questions are of only addition, now subtraction sign is there. Okay, so these are the questions, first, second, third and fourth. So I will do these parts now. Now let's understand. Simplify the following equation, that means you have to just operate whatever functions they have said. Generally by looking you can say that addition and subtraction you have to done of the rational number. Okay, and whenever you are doing the solving this kind of question, first convert into single sign, like plus minus two signs are there. Okay, so convert them into single sign. Now see the solution. So this is my first part. First I will solve the bracket. For solving the bracket, 9 and 15 denominators are not same, that's why I cannot subtract. Therefore I take the LCM so that I can make the denominators same. So when I take the LCM, it is 45. Now I convert my denominators equal to 45. 9 5s are 45, 15 3s are 45. Now same numbers I will provide to the numerator. Okay, now you can see 4 5s are 20, 8 3s are 24, 9 5s are 45, 15 3s are 45. Now you can see that the denominators are same. Now you can operate 45 as it is, 20 minus 24. Now when you subtract 20 from 24, answer is 4. But check which numeric value is greater. Yes, 24 is greater and it is negative. So the answer will also be negative. And when you are solving the bracket, rest of the things like 1 minus, that you are carrying as it is. Don't forget to write this number, okay? Because you are solving the bracket, rest of the things will be carried down as it is. Now bracket will be opened, minus minus, answer will be plus. 2 minus signs are there, minus minus plus. Now again you will take the LCM because you have to make the denominators same. Now multiply with 45 here and here also. So 45 and 45, 45 upon. Now add the numbers, 45 plus 4 upon 45, 49 upon 45. Now it is improper fraction. Why improper fraction? Because numerator is greater than denominator, and whenever you are having an improper fraction, you have to convert that into mixed fraction. Okay, you know the process. If you don't know, I will tell you again. like that. 45 into 45 minus 4. Okay, so this is your whole number which comes here, and this is remainder here, 45 as it is. Okay, okay. From there also you can write down, because 1 plus 4 upon 45 means that this is your whole part. It is a whole complete number. It is a whole number and is a fraction number. So you can write down here also same. The same answer you are getting now, you can write down that also. Okay, but no problem. If you cannot do directly, you can solve like that. Okay, concept should be understood that why I am getting this answer. Okay, this is the way to get the answer. Now I will move to the second part. Okay, this is my second part. Here you can see denominators are not same, that's why I have to take the LCM. Now you can see that 8 2 just 16. So 2 is a common factor, then 4 is a common factor, and so on. And whenever you are having any common factor, then LCM is very necessary that you take like that, okay, with the complete method. But if there is no common factor, then you can multiply directly. Now if you are taking the LCM, LCM will be 48. LCM will be 48. Now after that, my second task is to convert my denominators equal to 48. Now read the table. 8 6s are 48, 16 3s are 48, 24 2s are 48. The same number you will provide to numerators. Now 3 6s are 18, 5 3s are 15, 2 1s are 2. And denominators 8 6s are 48, 16 3s are 48, 24 2s are 48. Now you can see that denominators are same. So we'll write down it is as it is and merge the figures of numerator. 18 plus 15 plus 2. If you add these numbers, you will get 35 upon 48. And this is your